We're joined now from California by Patrick Marley, one of our Madison Bureau reporters who was covering last night's debate. Patrick, first give us your first thanks for getting up and, on the time change, but what was your general sense of the governor's performance last night?
Well, he had some good moments. You know, he took on Trump early on, and that was, I think, probably his best moment. The difficulty for him was that with 11 people on the stage, again, a lot of attention on Trump, that he didn't get a lot of face time. He only got 3 questions. He had to really fight to get on the screen when he could.
Yeah, so what, you know, as the governor and his team is waking up and getting oriented again today, how do you think they're feeling about the performance last night?
Well, they had a full-on contingent in the spin room. The governor was there. Unlike the first debate, he went and talked to reporters right afterward. He said that he thought he did what he aimed to do, and his supporters were saying that he had, you know, shown that he was willing to take on Trump in a gentlemanly fashion. That they took much that from the fact that Trump didn't further attack him after that initial exchange, and they thought that he'd done what he needed to do. The question is it enough? His polls have been so bad lately that he really needed a boost from this. And I think there's going to be a lot of questions about, you know, not was this good or bad, but was it great? Was it good enough to get him to the, you know, continue on to the
right,
next
yeah,
day?
Yeah, that's my next question. I mean, a lot of times it's this perception battle. So the first time people had probably higher hopes and he didn't meet them. Maybe now the expectations were lower and he may have surpassed them. But, you know, he's talking to donors this afternoon. Has he done enough, in your mind, to, you know, keep this thing going, at least to see how it plays out with Trump and Fiorina and some of the others?
One thing that the Walker's team really felt that they needed to do this time that they might not have done a good enough job on last time is framing how things went post-debate. They felt like in the initial days after the first debate, it was perceived that he had done just fine, and then only, you know, 5 days or so later did this perception sink in that he had faded into the background. And so I think they're pushing back on that and trying to frame it as they see it as quickly as they can, and that's why the governor was probably out there last night talking to reporters as much as he did. He did a lot of media. That's why he's got this donor call with his campaign manager, Rick Wiley, is to reassure everybody and tell them that things are going okay. You know, they don't believe the polls that are out there nationally. They think that they're doing just fine, but they have to recognize that there's this narrative out there that he's slumped in the public polling, he's really dropped. And so they need to make sure that that message doesn't affect their fundraising.
Yeah. One of the other headlines this week that you were in Las Vegas before you were in California covering the governor's, you know, proposals on federal unions. Did it surprise you that he didn't find a way to work that into the conversation at all yesterday, and that it didn't get much, you know, national attention when he made such a bold pronouncement this week?
Right. I mean, it definitely surprised his team. One of his aides told me, when I asked why didn't it get talked about, they thought he was going to be asked about it, and he wasn't. He did at the end, in his closing statement, raise some labor issues, but it wasn't center stage, which is interesting. I mean, it's a pretty dramatic proposal, and none of the other candidates are talking about it. I think that's a sign of the trouble that Walker is in, is that he's not being perceived as relevant at the moment.
All right, and lastly, where does the governor go from here? Now he's his on again, off again, on again. Visit to Michigan is on, but where then? Iowa? What's his strategy going forward?
Yeah, so he had these events in California and Michigan. He canceled them both. They were for this weekend, and then he put the Michigan one back on. Obviously, this is in California, so a lot of the California media was asking him, "What's this about? Is this showing that the California Party isn't important enough?" He said that he just couldn't miss this Iowa Faith and Freedom Forum this weekend. Multiple candidates are going to be there that he felt he absolutely needed to be there. So he's in Iowa, Michigan, and South Carolina this weekend. South Carolina, another crucial early state.
All right, and you'll be back in Wisconsin soon, no doubt. So thanks for joining us and covering the debate last night.
Yeah, thanks a lot, Greg.